This is a short video showing you how to add a single observation to iNaturalist via a browser, using this photograph as an example. First, from anywhere in iNaturalist, I'm going to hover over my screen name in the upper right-hand corner and select Add under Observations. This is the Add Observation screen. On the left, I can add taxonomic information, enter the date and time of my observation, and write any notes I want to share. In the middle here is where I can input location information, and on the right I can add photos and sounds as evidence of my observation. First I'm going to click Choose Files and search for the photo on my hard drive. My camera was set to the correct time and date when the photo was taken, so selecting Sync Observation with Metadata will tell iNaturalist to use the date and time of my photo for the observation. I can also enter a date in manually on the left side of the page. If I have multiple photographs of an organism, I can select more than one photo to upload. Next, I'm going to add a location for my observation. I took this photo in Tilden Regional Park, so I'm going to type that into the search box. Google has taken me to the center of the park, so I'm going to use the map to search for the trail I was on. And there we are. Now, when I tap on this area, you'll see there's a pin with a small circle around it. If I tap on the pin, I can use one of these control dots to make the circle larger or smaller, showing how accurate this location is. That looks about right. Each observation on iNaturalist can only be for one species. Since there are several organisms in this photo, I'm choosing the spider for this observation. I know it's a crab spider, but I'm not sure exactly which species it is, so I'm going to start typing in crab spider, then selecting crab spiders from the taxa list that pops up. And in the notes section, I'm going to type in on the left so that people will know specifically which organism in the photo this observation is referring to. Okay, I filled out every field I can, so I'm going to save the observation. If I want to add another observation, I can click on Save and Add Another, but for this video, I'm just going to click Save. And there we go. My observation is saved to iNaturalist. It can now be added to a project, and other members of the iNaturalist community can see it and help me with identification. The photo may take a moment to process, but you can see that iNaturalist has automatically added the date and time of my observation, as well as the location, identification, and the note that I wrote.